and Hydrolutris, more commonly known as sea otters, are extremely fascinating creatures to study. Sea otters are, of course, living organisms. They sexually reproduce to populate, they metabolize, they grow and develop, they have adapted through the process of evolution over time, and they are made up of eukaryotic cells.
Sea otters are the smallest marine mammals, weighing between 49 to 99 pounds when they are full grown. They can usually grow up to be about 1.2 to 1.5 meters long, and they can live up to 23 years. They also happen to be the heaviest members of the Mustelae family, commonly known as the weasel family. Other members of the weasel family include badgers, river otters, weasels, and ferrets. Sea otters are a part of the Animalia kingdom, the Chordata phylum, the Mammalia class, the Carnivora order, the Mustelae family, the Anhydra genus, and the Luteris species.
The exact origins of sea otters are unknown today, but scientists believe that their ancestors existed between 5 million to 7 million years ago, near the Pliocene and Miocene periods. Scientists also hypothesize that their ancestors were land mammals that moved into the water to hide from predators and look for food, much like modern-day sea otters. Once their ancestors entered the water, they developed their characteristics to help them better adapt to the water, such as their waterproof fur coats and webbed feet. These all were obtained through deletion or insertion of DNA bases, creating a mutation, then sexual reproduction, where the male's sperm and female's egg combine, containing the new mutation, and natural selection, where only those with the new adaptation survive.
Sea otters also happen to have quite the hefty appetite. They eat around 25% of their body weight daily to make up for their high metabolism. Their diet consists of over 40 different types of marine organisms, such as mussels, sea urchins, snails, and clams. Because much of their prey are animals with hard outer shells, they use rocks as tools to crack them open.
Sea otters' digestive systems are fairly similar to that of humans. It starts in the mouth and ends in the rectum. The rest of the system is composed up of a liver, a pancreas, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, and gallbladder. They do not need any specific digestive enzymes to consume their food, like some of the other creatures they compete for food with, such as the orchid sea star, who uses digestive enzymes to get their stomachs into hard-shelled organisms, like mussels, to get the meat out. The food runs through the system, and any nourishment is saved and used for energy, whilst everything else is dumped as waste. The stomach breaks down the food into tiny monomers, and as it passes through the rest of the system, the useful pieces are saved and the rest keep moving.
Sea otters are also prey to many different predators. Humans and great white sharks are their biggest predators. However, there is a parasite currently affecting many sea otters. This parasite is a protozoan and is named Toxoplasma gondii. It can infect all warm-blooded mammals, but it is a parasite that is more commonly passed around through cats on land. Cats get this from hunting rodents and birds, and they pass it on to the environment through their feces. 15 to 18% of the U.S. population actually carry Toxoplasma gondii, but because the body doesn't fight it, the parasite stays dormant. This parasite is passed to the sea through oocytes from cats that end up attaching to kelp, which is then eaten by snails and other kelp-eating organisms who are then eaten by sea otters.
Humans also hunt sea otters for their fur and in some places like Alaska for their meat as well. The single greatest threat to sea otters are oil spills, which are due to human activity. On the other hand, sharks, although they kill sea otters, don't usually eat them. Parasites, like most parasites, take nutrition from sea otters but try not to kill them. Sea otters also have a few land predators such as coyotes who both kill and eat them.
However, even though sea otters have a lot of predators, scientists still make an effort to help them. By using the scientific method such as observation, measurement, experiment, and the formulation and testing and modification of hypothesis, the scientists Sean Larson, Ron Jameson, Michael Enternine, Terry Jones, and Roberta Hall looked and studied sea otters during and after the period where humans were hunting them for fur, to see if there was any interpopulation change because of it.
By using flipper tissue and whole blood samples from both sea otters now and sea otters before the fur trade, taken from an archaeological museum's specimens of sea otters, they were able to conclude that sea otters did increase in interpopulation genetic relationships due to fur trade.
All of these predators are why sea otters keep a land and water ecosystem cycle. Sea otters are also predators themselves. They are apex predators, which are alpha predators, in the nearshore ecosystem, which is the ecosystem around shallow waters, coasts, and beaches. They are keystone species, meaning the ecosystem depends on them and would change drastically without them because of their importance to the health and stability of the ecosystem. and although they are relatively peaceful creatures, they can be vicious if a cub of theirs is hassled with.
Sea otters also help save our Earth. Unlike humans who pollute the world and increase climate change with hairspray, cars, and the mass farming of cows, sea otters help reduce the amount of CO2 that lingers in our atmosphere. Sea otters are considered a keystone species because of their importance in the marine ecosystem. By eating sea-grazing animals, such as the sea urchins, sea otters help make sure that these animals don't eat up all of the kelp in the underwater sea ecosystem, thus helping many other species who rely on kelp for habitat and overall survival. Not to mention, when sea otters are feeling lazy or really tired, they make themselves little kelp beds to lie in. The kelp takes CO2 from the air and, with the help of sunlight and water, transforms it into sugar fuel, releasing oxygen back into the air, giving us clear air to breathe.
There are also many fun facts that are rarely known about sea otters, such as scientists tagging and tracking many groups of sea otters around the world, but still not having a complete idea of them or their behavior. Sea otters also have a little pouch underneath their forearm where they store food and their favorite rock.
When they are small pups, they cannot swim, so their mothers carry them around on their stomachs until they learn how to swim. Sea otters are also very intelligent animals, which means they can be taught lots of cool tricks, like how to dunk a basketball. When they travel in groups, it is called a raft of sea otters. They are stronger in numbers, but they do not need to travel as a pack. If they are ever in packs, it is simply because they like being around each other. Sea otters also hold hands when they sleep at night so they don't drift far from one another. When they are napping, they cover their eyes with their paws. They do this because it's a comfortable place to keep their short paws out of the cold water.
Not to mention, they're meticulously clean. After eating, not only do they wash their fur, but they wash their teeth and paws as well. And unlike most other sea creatures, sea otters do not have a thick layer of fat, also known as blubber, keeping them warm in cold waters. They rather depend upon their thick fur coats to keep them warm. Lastly, sea otters were hunted to the point of near extinction in the early 20th century, leaving only 1,000 to 2,000 sea otters left, and in 1977, when the Endangered Species Act was passed by a bunch of scientists, sea otters were put on the list, thus prohibiting the further hunting of sea otters and making them a protected species in a vast majority of Earth's water.
And although they are being protected now, sea otters still aren't safe. With their population currently decreasing, they are at risk of going to near extinction again in the near future. And with more than 300 sea otters who died on the beaches in Homer, Alaska in 2015, that near future could be closer than you think. If you would like to help, you can adopt a sea otter today at worldwildlife.org.